If you haven't had a chance yet, I'm giving away an RTX 3080 Ti 12GB graphics card. So if you want to enter, I'll show you how. Keep watching this video. So you have a dual PC stream setup, or you want to use one because you have two computers and you want to know how to set it up. My name is Murray. I'm a filmmaker and editor, and I live stream on Twitch. So if you have any questions, come say hi. Link is down below. To set this up, first you need to understand that having a dual PC stream will implement new problems into your stream setup. If you have a single PC stream, it's a very simple and easy workflow. Now you will have to have a pretty decent computer to be able to have a single PC stream. You probably have two computers that are mediocre or decent computers, and you want to be able to utilize both of them to spread the load. Keep in mind, and you might have experienced this already, that video and audio are going to be difficult to get from your gaming PC to your streaming PC and still be able to hear it and see it on your gaming monitor. I have solutions to that. I've done videos in the past. One of my most popular did really well, and a lot of people really helped. But in addition to having a dual PC stream, you have to have some strong audio equipment, and sometimes that can get pretty pricey. A lot of people aren't able to afford a GoXLR, which is just over $500. And I get it, that's a little expensive. Even a GoXLR mini at, I think it's $250 or somewhere around there, is still a lot. Some people want to get going right away with the gear they already have. I'm going to show you step by step on how to set this up, so please watch the entire video. It will show you how to do everything bit by bit. It'll show you how to get your video from your computer, your gaming PC, to your monitor, as well as get it through your capture card into your stream PC. I'm also going to show you how to get your audio to your headset so that you can hear your game and let your stream hear it on your stream PC. You don't have to use any expensive hardware, just a couple extra cables that you'll need though. Adam, enjoy editing this. All right, so if you want to have a dual PC stream, first you need to understand the bare minimum requirements when it comes to your gaming computer. So first you need a graphics card that has two outputs. So you could either have an HDMI and a DisplayPort, or two HDMIs, but you need at least one HDMI output on that graphics card. I'm talking about the GPU here. If you do not have a graphics card on your gaming PC, a dual PC setup is not gonna work. If you have only an HDMI output on your graphics card and no other outputs, that's okay. There is a workaround, but it's not 100% guaranteed, and I'll tell you how to do that in just a second. First, connect your HDMI cable into your graphics card on your gaming PC. Then connect the other end of that HDMI cable into your capture card. Then with the provided USB-C cable that comes with the HD60S in this model, for example. There's other models that come with their own cables as well. Connect that USB-C cable into a USB 3.0 on your streaming PC. Now your capture card should look like this. You don't need to use the HDMI out on your HD60S, because that's if you had a console or if you only had one output on your graphics card. So for example, let's say you don't have a DisplayPort or even a VGA coming out of your graphics card and just one HDMI output. So what you can do is on the HDMI out on your graphics card, connect an HDMI to that and then the other end into your monitor. Keep in mind that your monitor frame rate and hertz will be limited to the specifications of your capture card. So in my example, the Elgato HD60S can do 1080p 60 frames per second, which is not bad. It's still pretty decent. Now connect your microphone to your gaming PC. Most people use an XLR or USB microphone, and an XLR microphone has an audio interface connected to the PC via USB. So assuming you have, for example, the Behringer UMC22 or the Focus Scarlett, Wright, whatever you call it, is the more popular one people use, that still plugs into the PC via USB. Next, what you want to do is connect an audio splitter to your USB microphone headphone jack or to the audio interface you have connected. This way you can split your game slash team slash music audio between your headset and another line out. So for example, connect your headphones to your audio splitter that's connected to whatever device you have for your microphone. Then connect another 3.5mm audio jack male to male, connect one end into that audio splitter and the other end into the line in or mic in on your capture card. So this cable is acting as a bridge between your gaming PC and your stream PC. So what happens is your game, your Discord team chat, your Spotify, whatever browser you use, all that audio is gonna go through that splitter into your headset. Additionally, it's gonna go through that cable into the line in on your capture card. Next, right click on your gaming PC desktop and go to display settings. Make sure that you see all the monitors and capture cards that are plugged in. If you don't see your capture card being picked up here, and you do have it plugged into your graphics card, then you most likely have a faulty capture card. This has happened occasionally, I haven't seen it very often, but one of the members in the Discord community did bring this up, and so far that's what we've been able to diagnose. Keep in mind that if you talk to Elgato, assuming you have a Elgato capture card, they can help you fix some issues depending on what it might be. So be sure to extend these displays, do not duplicate them. If you find that your monitor's hertz or refresh rate is capped or not as high as it should be, try this. In the advanced display settings section, choose the monitor you want and then choose the refresh rate down below. There you go, all fixed. So now with the audio on your gaming PC, it needs to get to your capture card. It hasn't been set up yet. So what you need to do is right click on your system sound icon in your taskbar on the bottom right of your screen. Then click open sound settings. Make sure the output is set to your headphone output on your USB microphone or your audio interface. This is the device that you connected your audio splitter to that goes to your headphones and to the line in on your capture card. Now get another 3.5mm male-to-male audio cable. Connect this to the headphone jack on your gaming PC or line out on your gaming PC. Then connect this to the microphone or line in on your streaming PC. This is gonna act as your microphone bridge between your gaming and streaming PC. But we're not done yet, we've got a few additional steps. Go to your sound settings by right-clicking on the sound icon in your taskbar and click open sound settings. Click on the sound control panel button and then click the recording tab. Scroll to where your microphone is and right-click on it. Click properties and then go to the listen tab. Make sure that listen to this device is checked on and playback through device is selected as your 3.5mm audio cable that's plugged into the headphone or line out on your gaming PC. Keep in mind that everything I've described software-wise and anything you've seen on the screen so far is on your gaming PC. We haven't even touched the streaming PC yet, so if you've done anything on your streaming PC at this point, you need to rewatch the video because we're not there yet. We're just setting up your gaming PC, making sure everything's set the way it should be before we move forward. Next, what we need to do is send the video through your capture card into your stream PC. There's two ways to doing this, and this first way I'm going to tell you how to do it is to help not limit your refresh rate on your monitor. Some people lose their hertz or refresh rate. This is how you avoid that. So download OBS Studio on your gaming PC. Don't download Streamlabs onto your gaming PC, and don't worry, you're not going to be streaming from your gaming PC. This is simply to capture the video on your main computer screen and send it to your capture card. So what you need to do is once you've downloaded OBS Studio on your gaming PC, set up one scene where you create your main display capture. All right, once you've created that, right click on your program screen and do full screen projector to your capture card. This is going to be sending whatever OBS sees to your capture card. And ideally, that's your main computer screen that you want to show where your game is at. Now, depending on what monitor you have, you need to mirror those settings on your main monitor in OBS. So go to your settings and in video output, make sure that you're doing the base canvas as the resolution that your monitor is. And make sure that the output or the scaled resolution is the same. Don't do 1080p or anything lower than what your monitor is because you'll lose your quality. And make sure that the FPS is at 60 frames per second. Okay, now that you've completely set up your gaming PC from your audio to your video, we can move on to the streaming PC. Now, depending on if you use OBS Studio or Streamlabs OBS, this process is gonna be very much similar. So with your streaming PC software open, create your scene and then right click and select video capture device. Select your capture card, and once that's created, an audio source will be created in that scene. This audio source is gonna be your game, music, Spotify, your Discord, and anything that you're hearing in your headset from your gaming PC. Remember, this is the audio splitter going to the line in on your capture card. You might also have to turn the volume down on the source in OBS on your streaming PC because it might be a little loud, depending on how you have things set up. It just is unique to every computer. Next, go to your settings in OBS on your streaming PC and click the audio tab. Disable the desktop audio 1 and 2. Unless you want to hear your audio alerts on your gaming PC, you can create your browser source on your gaming PC OBS and import your link from your alerts so you can actually hear your alerts there. That's a way you can hear those alerts, but if you don't want to hear the alerts, then make sure that you enable desktop audio 1 on the audio channel in your streaming software on your streaming PC. Then on mic/auxiliary audio 1, set that to default. This is automatically going to choose the microphone or the line in on your streaming PC. If it doesn't choose that by default, make sure you manually choose that input. This is going to be the microphone from your gaming PC. So that audio cable we connected to the headphones or line out on your gaming PC, and the other end of it into your streaming PC through the microphone or line in, that's going to be your microphone. And that's what we're selecting here in OBS. One thing to note here is that you might get some audio hiss or hum because you're using audio cables and they might be going over power cables. You're gonna get some audio interference. So a really useful tool is this ground noise isolator. It's very useful. You can plug it in between the lines on either inputs, so you can put it into your capture card and you can put it into your streaming PC before you plug the audio into the line in. This will help remove that audio interference and just clean up your microphone and game audio completely. I have one of them. They're definitely very necessary when it comes to a dual PC stream. In some situation, you're gonna get some audio hiss and hum here and there. And also, the longer cables you have, the more audio interference you're gonna get. That ground noise isolator I just mentioned is down below. There's a link there. It does support the channel and a lot of people really love to use those. In the previous dual PC video I did, that was also mentioned, and people have really loved that piece of gear. It does help fix your audio problems as well. If this video was helpful in any way, please consider leaving a like and subscribe. I do live stream Monday to Friday Pacific time, 8 a.m. every day. So feel free to come say hi if you have any questions. Maybe if you're having any problems, definitely let me know and we can help troubleshoot it. If you do want to enter for a graphics card giveaway, the RTX 3080 Ti 12GB version, link is right over here. Go check it out. Entries end on October 31st, 2021. You can enter for as many chances as you get. Subscribers get extra entries, 5x chance of winning the graphics card, just because I really do appreciate the support from all the subscribers. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time, but until then, make something great.